I was born standing up and talking back. My daddy was a green-eyed mountain
Hey, Biscuit Film fans, I'm your host, Anika Chung. Welcome to my channel. Baz Luhrmann's latest film, Elvis, released by Warner Bros., premiered at the Cannes International Film Festival on May 25th with a standing ovation, indeed, and an international release June 24th. The film has grossed $261 million worldwide against its $85 million budget, becoming the second highest grossing music biopic of all times behind Bohemian Rhapsody. That is truly impressive. It's starring Austin Butler, Tom Hanks, Helen Thomson, and Olivia DeJonge. The film explores the life and music of Elvis Presley, played by Austin Butler, seen through the prism of his complicated relationship with his villainous manager, calling Tom Parker, played by Tom Hanks. The story develops into a complex dynamic between Presley and Parker, spanning over 20 years, from Presley's rise to fame to his on decent ed stardom against the backdrop of the evolving cultural landscape and the loss of innocence in America. Central to that journey is one of the most significant and influential people in Elvis's life, including his love, Priscilla Presley, played by Olivia DeJonge. Let's talk about it. I've been a fan of Elvis's music and so is my mother, but I've always been curious of the story of how he became the iconic singer that we love. In the beginning, in the scene, Elvis is so drawn to this gospel revival in Tupelo, Mississippi. He was like about 13, embracing the sound, feeling the spirit. I've known for a fact by watching his performances in his younger days, singing rhythm and blues, and those unforgettable dance moves, spending time in Memphis on Beale Street, hanging and jamming with other fellow musicians, including B.B. King. He was so comfortable, and you can see the expression on his face. And of course, that groovy pink suit that he wore looked fantastic on him. Elvis embraced African-American music, musicians, and culture. It didn't matter where you were from, he just loved people. He was that type that loved to travel the world and just bring music and happiness. And as for Colonel Tom Parker, although he was Elvis's manager, in charge of shows, touring, merchandising, he was just plain greedy. Such a villainous manager blocked Elvis from doing any international tours. People just wanted to meet Elvis, but they couldn't because they can't travel the country. That truly broke Elvis's heart because he wanted to meet his fans around the world. And I think he would've been better off with another manager. That is just my two cents, y'all. But Elvis was Elvis without Tom Parker. I'm just saying. Although this movie was long, it was amazing from beginning to end. Austin Butler truly captured the essence of legendary Elvis Presley. The voice, the dance moves, definitely to the T. It felt like Bill and Ted brought Elvis from the 50s into the 21st century, and he's sharing his story at the same time, an unforgettable concert. Seriously, watching the film definitely made me want to make a trip one day to Memphis, visit all the cool places, ride that classic 50s car on Beale Street, visiting Sun Studio, one of the birthplaces of rhythm and blues and rock and roll. And most of all, visiting Graceland. Awesome, Butler. If you do see this, can you do a 1 hour Elvis tribute? That'd be awesome. I would love that so much. There were moments I just wanted to get up and dance, watching the scene on Beale Street, hearing that sound was so good. It was awesome to see B.B. King and also Big Mama Thornton sing Hound Dog. However, there was one singer Elvis mentioned, but I wish they had a mini scene with him, James Brown. He was good friends with Elvis Presley. Seriously, how iconic would it be to see James Brown and Elvis Presley share the stage together, you know, bringing peace? That would have been awesome.
Elvis was making his comeback and had played the International Hotel in Las Vegas. It's now the Las Vegas Hilton. Mr. Brown was had been doing a show the week prior to Elvis coming in, and he was ending his show at the International Hotel there. And the next thing, they got to singing bars of gospel music, and they were teasing each other. Elvis would say, James, I bet you don't know so-and-so and so-and-so. And James Brown loved Elvis, and Elvis loved James Brown. But anyway, they put on a mini concert there. James Brown sat out on the piano stool with him, and they sang gospel music for about 2 hours.
As for Tom Hanks portraying the Colonel and seeing the story through his eyes, telling his story, I think Tom Hanks did a fantastic job portraying him. And the funniest part was every time when you see the Connell, you hear a little villain music playing in the background. Actually, that was actually pretty funny. And majority of the film was actually filmed in Australia. Seriously, how they made Graceland and Beale Street was incredible. The exterior was so detailed. The spirit of Graceland was in Australia. I was like, damn, that is amazing. This is truly Oscar-worthy film. Austin deserves it. And most of all, he represented Elvis very well to the T. The director did a fantastic job bringing this biopic on a whole new level, including the people that inspired Elvis. If you guys haven't seen this film, I highly recommend. You'll have a great time, probably singing and, you know, dancing. And make sure you get a comfy couch, pillows, and some popcorn. I had a wonderful time watching this movie. I give Elvis 5 golden stars. I'm your host, Anika Chung, and I'll see you next time on my next motion picture movie reviews. Love yourself always, and remember, be excellent to each other. All right, guys, I'll see you next time. Pictures. Cheers, and that is a wrap. That's terrible. That is a wrap. There, guys, that's all, folks. Thank you very much. Elvis, we love you.